What's up, A&O? It's Jake and Bailey here, and we are here to give you this week's Devo. We hope you guys are having a great summer, and that you're just having a lot of fun and enjoying time with friends and stuff. And yeah, so we're just going to go ahead and just hop right into this, and Bailey's going to read.
Today we're going to be reading in Ephesians 2. It's 11 through 22. I'm just going to read 11 through 18 first, and we'll talk about that a little bit, and then Jake will close us off with 19 through 22. So if you'll start in verse 11 with me. Don't forget that you Gentiles used to be outsiders. You were called uncircumcised heathens by the Jews, who were proud of their circumcision, even though it affected only their bodies and not their hearts. In those days, you were living apart from Christ. You were excluded from citizenship among the people of Israel, and you did not know the covenant promises God had made to them. You lived in this world without God and without hope. But now you've been united with Christ Jesus. Once you were far away from God, but now you've been brought near to him through the blood of Christ. For Christ himself has brought peace to us. He united Jews and Gentiles into one people when, in his own body on the cross, he broke down the wall of hostility that separated us. He did this by ending the system of law with its commandments and regulations. He made peace between Jews and Gentiles by creating in himself one new people from the two groups. Oh, I think just reloaded. Together as one body, Christ reconciled both groups to God by means of his death on the cross, and our hostility toward each other was put to death. He brought this good news of peace to you Gentiles who were far away from him, and peace to the Jews who were near. Now all of us can come to the Father through the same Holy Spirit because of what Christ has done for us. So I'm sure if you guys have been on social media at all in the past couple weeks, there's been a lot of division just in our country over starting with the coronavirus and then about all of the race things that are going on and as well as politics. And so something that we kind of wanted to just highlight were three or four points of just talking about peace and oneness in Christ. So we'll start with verse 14 through 15. It just basically talks about how Christ himself has brought peace to us. He united the Jews and the Gentiles. And I think that's really important to think about right now with all of this division that's going on. Christ is the bringer of peace. He breaks down the walls of hostility that are separating different groups, whether it's race or Christians and non-believers and all of this stuff with politics. It's mainly just Christ. That's the only thing that's going to be able to bring peace right now is the focus on Christ as the bringer of peace. And he's the one that can bring unity between different groups of people.
Yeah, and I think what's cool that with that is just like that was all done through his death on the cross. Like mm-hmm. he died so that all of that could happen, and he died so that all of us, so that all of us could be one body, so that we could be one body with Christ, and that's what it says in verse 16. It says that together as one body, Christ reconciled both groups to God by means of his death on the cross, and our hostility towards each other was put to death. And so it's just really important to remember that, like, even with all of this stuff going on, like, we are one body. We were called and created to be together with Christ and together with each other and to fight for that peace and that oneness and that unity as the body of Christ. Like, we can't do this without each other. Like, Bailey has different gifts that I don't have, and I have different gifts that she doesn't have. And without those two, you know, people, sons and daughters of Christ coming together to fulfill the mission, it just doesn't work as easily. And so it's really important to remember that we were created to be together, to be in unity, and to love others and bring peace to each other.
Yeah, which brings us to our next point. What do we do with this? All throughout the Bible in different places, we're called to be peacemakers. So what is our duty? What is our responsibility as Christians and followers of Christ? Well, we bring peace. So how do we do that? In verses 18, the last part of that first section, it says, now all of us can come to the Father through the same Holy Spirit because of what Christ has done for us. So we just wanted to kind of highlight that we have the Holy Spirit in us, and that's what truly can bring unity and help us to be peacemakers, because we've been equipped with the Holy Spirit, who knows exactly how to define peace, because that is who he is. He brings us peace on the inside, but also helps us show peace outwardly. So just just remember to bring peace wherever you go by using the Holy Spirit and what God has blessed us with in the Holy Spirit, of being able to share God's love with other people, whether that's just letting somebody know you care, if they're going through a rough time or they're really struggling with all of the things going on in the world. Help be a peacemaker in their life by sharing the Holy Spirit with them, by praying over them, asking them how they can, how you can pray for them in this time, and how you can help and how you can be a comfort and a peace to them through this.
Yeah, so I mean, the result of all this is what we see in verses 19 through 22. I'll make it a little bigger here so I can read it. But it says, "So now you Gentiles are no longer strangers and foreigners. You are citizens along with all of God's holy people. You are members of God's family. Together we are his house, built on the foundation of the apostles and the prophets. And the cornerstone is Christ Jesus himself. We are carefully joined together in him, becoming a holy temple for the Lord. Together, or through him, you Gentiles are also being made part of this dwelling where God lives by his Spirit." And so, like, that's just saying, like, it's through Christ that we are all able to come together as one body, as one house, and he is the cornerstone. He is the one that keeps it all held together. Like, we can't do anything without him to bring peace to our nation, to our city, to our schools, to our families. Without Christ, we can't do that. But through him and through the Holy Spirit living in us, it's totally possible. And so we just want to encourage you guys, like, as you go throughout this next week, think about ways that you can be a peacemaker or a peace bringer. Like, for example, like, one thing I just tried to do this week was I posted on Facebook, like, I'm kind of over all of this, like, politics and everything. I want to hear what's one good thing that happened to you today. And it's been really cool to see, like, all of the awesome comments of people. Some people just saying, "I had coffee this morning." Like, hey, if that's what's good for them, then great. I'm so glad that they were able to focus on that good. Some people were like, "Man, I had some of my friends challenge me and really be able to pray for me in a very difficult and tough situation." And that's so awesome to hear, because that's the body of Christ coming together and working together for the good of the church and for the good of our nation. And so just want to encourage you guys to think of ways that you can be a peace bringer this week, and go out there and do it and be bold and bring Christ with you, because that's the only way it's going to work. So we love you guys.
We're praying for you. We hope you have a really great week. And be peacemakers. Bring unity to everyone around you.
See you guys.
Bye.